Rudy and Eleanor Mendez. gentlemen, next here to your parents of the groom. Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause, please, for Mr. and Mrs. Rodolfo and Leticia Japlett. And now, ladies and gentlemen, next here to your godparents. Ladies and gentlemen, first, big round of applause for Miss Estrella Feliciano and Mr. Raimundo Galicia. And ladies and gentlemen, last but not least, of your godparents, here's Mrs. Emmer Malapiton and Mr. Ronaldo Malapiton. And now, ladies and gentlemen, if you make a little noise, here are your flower girl and ring bearer this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause. Here is Miss Jillian Mendez and Mr. Giovanni Fabian Malapiton Rodriguez. And now, Tony, can you please fade out? And ladies and gentlemen, here is your bridal party. And now, ladies and gentlemen, first, we introduce to you is here is your ushers. Big round of applause, please, for Mr. Vincent Ng and Mr. Christopher Ho. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here's your bridal party. Ladies and gentlemen, first, here's Miss Christina Nuki and Mr. Peter Ramos. And ladies and gentlemen, the sexiest man here next to the groom. Here is Miss Fatima. That's Fatima. Fatima. I'm sorry, I'm nervous. This is Fatima Feliciano and myself, Mr. Joseph Ursula Jr. My bad. Alright, come on, let me tell you something. At this time, here is Miss Trisha Japlett and Mr. Maui Mendez. And now, ladies and gentlemen, make some noise and here's your maid of honor and best man this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, first here is Mrs. Kimberly Chin and Mr. Alan Aguilar. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the first time I've seen Alan dance. And ladies and gentlemen, last but not least, big round of applause, please, for Mrs. for Miss Sharia within the one and Mr. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I need to please stand. People that are sitting down, I need to please stand. And as I say once again at all my weddings, let's make some noise! As we welcome Lewis and Haskell for 2010, my friend and yours, Mr. and Mrs. Jerome. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the king. As a bride and groom, let's cut the cake for the first time. Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, if you do have a camera, this would be a great opportunity to take pictures. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the cake cutting.
Across the water, across the ocean, under the open sky, oh my, oh baby, I'm trying.
Cut that cake!
Oh, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, the bride and groom let's cut the cake. I'm emotional. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please direct attention to the dance floor as they take their first dance as a married couple. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, Mr. and Mrs. Jerome and Melanie Chaplin.
My favorite station, like my favorite.
So big round of applause please for Mr. and Mrs. Mendez. If you please come up and say a few words about the bride.
Hi, my Melanie, we are coming to our family. Now I have another daughter.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Big round of applause once again for Mr. and Mrs. Japlet, ladies and gentlemen. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I have one question and one question for you only, as I ask once again. Ladies and gentlemen, are we hungry this evening? Yes, because I know you want some of that pork back there, because I do too. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, only out, the party horn is coming. So right now, ladies and gentlemen, dinner will be served in a few short minutes, so please sit back, relax, and enjoy, and we're not going anywhere, because we're going to party until the end. Yeah. Tony, cue the dinner music. Thank you. Speaker this evening. If you could please stand and give a great round of applause for Mr. Alan Aguilar.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I want to say how lovely and handsome everyone looks tonight. It's got to be the Hawaii. So, let me introduce myself. For those who don't know me, my name is Alan Aguilar. I've been friends with Jerome for about 20 years now, ever since fifth grade. The way we were introduced was through his brother, Sean, and I'm really shaking right now. Jerome, during that time, was into tennis and needed a couple hitting partners and targets. So he had Sean and me participate. From then on, friendships blossomed, and soon And so then I was over at their house and kind of became the adoptive brother they always teased. Jerome is more than a friend. He is family. He's a big brother I would want to have. He has always been there whenever I needed him, and I thank you for that. Hold on. I will always cherish all the good memories we've shared, such as back in the days with your Cutlass Supreme.
Wow.
Riding, going all the way to McFetridge, to Norwich, playing tennis all the time, and even during the Deception era. And even the bad ones, where I had to be the peacemaker between Jerome and Sean during their brotherly quarrels when we were younger. There'd be times where I'd be biking on my way to their house and I'd see Sean in the middle of the road, kind of holding his hand with tears running down his eyes. I'm like, what happened? It's like, and then a fight with Jerome, you know? I don't know. So, I mean, sorry to bring up. That's my mistake. Well, we really came a long way. And now here you are, opening a new and wonderful chapter of your life with Melanie. Melanie, I know I don't know you as well from the times that I've been able to chill with you. I do know that you're a sweet and caring person in the way that you treat your friends and your family. And I hope that I get to hang out with you and know you more. But I know I don't have to worry that Jerome and both of you are in good hands with each other. I can see that the two of you make each other happy and that you guys are perfect for each other. I want to say that I'm deeply honored to be one of your best men, and I thank the both of you from the very bottom of my heart for making me a part of your wonderful and joyous occasion. And what better place than here in Hawaii? Perfect weather. So, if everyone can raise their glass, I just want to let everyone know not to chug it down, because there's going to be a few more episodes. So, to Jerome and Melanie, for a healthy, fruitful, and a happy life together.
Yeah!
Cheers. Salute.
Ladies and gentlemen, please big round of applause for your best, one of your best men this evening, Mr. Alan Aguilar. And I must say, that was a very good speech for the end. I'm very impressed. You are impressing me every day, this guy. And if you please pass the mic now, as right now I'd like to hear a few words from the brother of the group, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause for peace for Mr. Christian Sean Zaplet.
Hello, hello. Again, for those of you that don't know me, I'm Sean, some of you know me as Christian.
Ow!
Brother, obviously, and the best man for the wedding, and I could not be more honored than being chosen for this, so thank you. First of all, let us all thank our parents, Ronnie and Ellen Mendez, Rodolfo and Leticia Jemplet. Without you, none of this would be possible. All of your hard work, devotion, time, and love allowed us to be here today. They sacrificed so much for the children, so thank you. And to everyone here today, you can be anywhere in the world right now, but you chose to be here with us, and for that, we are thankful. I think it's a reflection of Jerome and Melanie to see so many familiar faces here. All the families that traveled here, along with childhood friends. The fact that you are here shows the strength of loyalty and friendship we all share. And as you can tell, I'm going to take this opportunity to thank everyone. So, Jerome, growing with his brothers under the same roof, there were ups and downs, just like any other siblings. We fought about anything you can imagine. But we were able to share so many unforgettable memories. So I'm here to thank him and say I'm proud of him. I realize that being an older brother is not an easy task. As an older brother, you don't have the opportunity to have a sibling sibling point you in the right direction. Instead, you learn on your own, you make your own mistakes and find your own successes. All I had to do was sit back and watch. I didn't watch what to do, what not to do, what to say, how to say it, what I could get away with. So basically what I'm trying to say is that he helped me become the person I am today. And for that, I'm so very thankful and forever indebted to him. Melanie, either you have a ton of patience or you keep him in check. Or both. Regardless, I have no idea how you do. But seriously, you look amazing tonight. Both of you do. Thank you. Thank you for all that you have done for my brother and my family. You are always kind and gracious to us. And every time we spend time with our family, you fit right in. And most importantly, you make my brother unbelievably happy. Welcome to the family, and thank you from the bottom of my heart. And to both of you, now as Mr. and Mrs. Jaffelet, thank you for sharing your journey with us. You've taken us along with you from the beginning to the transformation of your house and opening the doors to all of us, to all the events leading up until today. Some people say, it's all about the journey. I think in this case, it's about the journey, your wedding day, and the amazing days you have in front of you. You have shown us how to love, be happy, and enjoy life. For that, thank you. Again, ladies and gentlemen, please raise your glasses. Get the thought, get anything left. And close your toast.
I'm on toast.
To lifelong happiness for Mr. and Mrs. Jeff.
This is amazing.
Thank you, Christian. And now if you could please pass the microphone as right now. Now we'd like to hear a few words from the maids of honor this evening. To hear a few words about bride and groom. So please pass the mic as we'd like to welcome, ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause for your first maid of honor this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause, please, for Mrs. Kimberly Shin.
Wedding here on the beautiful island of Oahu. Melanie and I have known each other for over 10 years. In this time, we've managed to play through the good times, weather through the tough moments, and coast through everything in between. I guess this is why Mrs. Mendez joked and called us husband and wife. But I won't bore everyone with all of my fond memories, since most of us are only here for a week, short week. But I will tell everyone here one thing. I have yet to meet a girl that will throw herself out of a plane at 16,000 feet to go skydiving and can be more than ecstatic to scrapbook for an entire weekend's journey. Mel is truly a unique individual. She is strong-willed but gentle-hearted, passionate but yielding. She is patient, generous, loving, and forgiving, all wrapped up in this pretty little person. She's proof that great things do come in small packages. Jerome, you are truly a lucky man. Most of you probably already know this already, but I'm gonna say it again. Mel is like a sister to me. She's so close to me that she even played a key part in why I am married right now. If it weren't for her subtle curiosity of Bruce's intentions with me, I wouldn't be her matron of honor today. But wait, what am I kidding? Mel's not subtle. And that's why we love her. Anyway, she is such a keystone in my life that she got ordained as a minister to marry Vince and myself. Ironically, I had a fair bit of influence in her relationship with Jerome, too. It was during one of our trips to Vegas. Mel was on the fence about whether or not she should accept that dinner invitation from Jerome. But I remember standing in front of the Bellagio fountain saying, "He's a nice guy, with an impeccable fashion sense." Yes, you've known him for 10 years already. You never know what can happen. So make like Nike and just do it. Well, we all know how that story unfolded. Over the last 6 years, I have watched these two grow and develop into the perfect candidates for this lifelong union known as marriage. Jerome's quirky sense of humor, complemented by Mel's perfect smile. Mel's sense of adventure, fueled by Jerome's passion for Hawaii. Jerome's exquisite culinary skills, adored by Mel's acute taste buds. The list goes on, but like I said before, most of us are only here for a week. I would love to do nothing more than to regale you all with our crazy antics, but we have a night filled with food, dancing, and fun ahead of us. So let me get back on track. Jerome, you probably know by now that you've got our stamp of approval. So I'm going to let you in on a little known secret. If you and Mel are ever at odds and you don't want to go to bed angry at each other, these two words will save you much sleep. They're so important that I've enlisted the help of an expert to demonstrate. Honey?
Oh, Lord. Please
Jerome, are you paying attention?
For a good time, call. Yes, dear.
Thanks, honey. Take this and use it well. These two words, when executed properly, will work like magic. Trust me.
Let me take another sip. Getting drunk over here. Woo! All right. And ladies and gentlemen, last but not least of the maids of honor, ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause, please, for Miss Sharia Lindenmore. Yes.
And last, I'm going to make this short and sweet. First of all, thank you all for coming. I would say, Melody, thank you for allowing me to be a part of this, but you never really asked me. I've known you, I think our anniversary is now 30 years. And I always say, we've known each other for 30 years and you still like me. So we became best friends, not by chance, but by chance and by choice, I'd say. So we've been through so much together. We've been through ups and downs, lost family members, births of new ones. And I will say, you are the most giving, loving... Oh. Just most loving and giving person I've ever met. And anyone who knows you or your family, you take everyone into your heart. And you love with all your heart. But don't ever cross your path, because anyone who knows, feel the wrath, because you're a little spitfire. They say, if I find true love, don't look for it. And I know when you two went on your first date, and you feel horror. And you screamed, and I knew.
Thank you.
you were so funny and you were so sweet, and I cannot imagine a picture to anyone more perfect for each other. You two handle each other, you balance each other, you love and fight like couples should. So just want to wish you both loving and happy life to your new family. I need Toby. So last toast, everyone please raise your glasses. Cheers.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for your maid of honor this evening, Miss Soria Bellini. Big round of applause. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, dessert will be coming out in a few minutes. Or actually, cake.
Actually, I'd like to say something.
Oh, snap! Oh!
Since everybody's glasses are still pretty full.
Oh. No, not really, Joel. Sure.
Oh, mine is. I'd like to finish it. And thanks everybody for coming out. Everybody from Chicago, Houston, any locals that have crashed because it was like advertised on the closed circuit TV. You guys have been the greatest. I can't believe that everybody's out here. That we had the maximum amount of people out here. We definitely didn't expect it. We love you all. We think of all of you as family. I mean, I have a new big brother. Really big brother. Bigger than I ever expected. But if you're gonna thank anybody, it's going to be Melanie. Melanie did so much for this. Without her determination, without her crafting skills. I mean, she made these things. The cake topper, she made these things. Out of clay. She did invitations. It was like a sweatshop without lead paint. But this is for you guys. This is for everybody. One more. Yeah. I want you to come. I'm gonna go. Cheers. Cheers. Thank you. Have some dessert.
Ladies and gentlemen, round of applause, please. So once again, for Mr. and Mrs. Exactly. I just come out of the phone, so sit down, relax. Take time. And singing the father-daughter dance song will be Mr. Bobby Mendez.
Oh my God. This is my dad's favorite song. I'm one of them, so. And I just made the track the night before we left, so hope you like it.
Your heart, for it's there.
time. Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I always will.
Mrs. Japlett, can you please come out to the dance floor at this time to join your son Jerome? Once again, a jumping round of applause, please, for Mrs. and Mr. Japlett and her son Jerome.
Yeah.
Melrome on the first one, so we got a little shot shot this evening. We're gonna mix it up, that's really fun. And ladies and gentlemen, make a little noise, because we are in Hawaii, ladies and gentlemen.